April. But the one that we are really excited about is the Jabra Panacast 24 video camera, which is here. This is the top price. And I will get more into that in a bit, okay? But I just want to make sure that everyone is here. Can we...
Oh, yeah, can be seen now.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Jin, you're not dressed up.
No time.
Okay. It's okay. You look frightful enough. You look result from a whole day of work.
The natural horror of work.
Yeah, the horror of work, which was also the thinking, by the way, behind tonight's top prize, right? You know, we're thinking that, you know, what could be more frightful than looking horrible on a Zoom call, right? And we all know we have to do many Zoom calls now because of the pandemic, unfortunately. So we figured like a camera like that would be a game changer, so to speak.
Filter.
Oh, sorry?
Beauty filter.
Oh yeah, beauty filters are... Wait, you mean the camera?
Yeah.
That's a... it kind of like, I wouldn't even say it's a filter. It kind of like enhances how you look. So I'm actually using it now, in case you...
Are you using a filter?
I am not, but I can...
The real thing, right?
I can demonstrate to y'all while we're waiting for the stragglers to log on. The rest of you, I hope you don't mind. But this is the Jabra Panacast 20 that I'm using right now. And I'm going to switch. I'm going to toggle over to my normal camera, okay, that I usually use that's inbuilt in my laptop. If you can see me. Wait 1 second. Do you see me?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
So you can see the difference, right? And then now I'm switching back again to Jabra. So anyway, I will talk more about our top price in a bit because we are super thankful to our sponsor for bringing that one in. Okay, I don't mean to stop the music and just have me rambling on, but Janet, can I just check if like most of the teams are in?
Yeah, should be. Yep, all in. All here.
Okay, all in. Look good. Let's start. Awesome. I am going to start sharing my screen with y'all. So let's do this.
Sam, we should be playing Werewolf, man. The outfit from Sam.
We should be what? Sorry?
We should be playing Werewolf. With the outfit, with your outfit.
Oh, the game, right? Yeah.
Or Werewolf.
Among Us.
Well, actually... Yeah, honey, you should mention that because that is round one. No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Okay, let's get started. I'm going to stop the music so it's not confusing for people, okay? All right, welcome to Media versus PR Trivia Night. It's a Halloween edition. We're 3 days away from Halloween, and this is Halloween weekend. I'm super excited, presented by the Singapore Press Club. Thank you so much for joining. We have 10 teams here today, if I'm not wrong, and everyone vying for, you know, at least one of the top three prizes. We only have three sets of prizes to give out tonight, but given that there are 10 teams, it means that, you know, I kind of jumped the gun a little bit.
Actually, it's not 10 teams now, since the Spur Wing are combined.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So we're 8.
1 second. My computer is lagging now. Tech issues. I'm pressing it, but it's not going to the next slide. How strange.
One using moment. PowerPoint?
Yeah, I'm using Google Slides. Sorry about that. Let's figure it out in a bit. I am just going to... Yeah, it should work. I don't see why it's not working. Okay, let me try sharing my screen again because that is very important for tonight. If we don't have the screen, we have no questions. And we have no questions, then we can win. Okay.
So Sam, is it, well, you can send it to me. I can help you play it. Although I can see the questions.
It's too late to volunteer. So as far as today goes, right, Janet will be doing a lot of the scoring and I obviously set the questions. So if you're not happy, look for me, okay? And if you have any disputes over the questions, like, you can always look for me. All right, what are we playing for tonight? The third prize, as we know, is worth $90. And this, you read this in our poster that went out and our invite that went out. A bottle of white wine worth $40. I'm not sure what kind of white wine it is, but I don't think it's too bad. And Even if you don't drink wine, you can enjoy the $50 dining voucher courtesy of the Fullerton Hotel. If not, there is also the second prize to gun for that's worth $193, a bottle of Alkentoshan 12-year-old single malt whiskey, as well as more vouchers from the Fullerton Hotel, more dining vouchers, all right? And of course, the top prize that we are all aiming for tonight, I believe, which is why we're all here, is the first prize worth $564. And other than, you know, the Fullerton Hotel dining vouchers, again, this time you get $100 worth of that, we are giving away a Jabra Panacast 20 video camera worth $464. And this is a camera that I'm using right now. And this is what you can see in here. And I am going to demonstrate one of the features that, you know, it actually can do. So there is a camera within a camera feature where you can, like, you know, demonstrate products and also, you know, people can see both the zoom in of the product and your face. But there's also something called the intelligent zoom, which is what I'm going to show you right now. So now you see me.
Oh, it's shifted.
Oh, but it's following me. I'm not even touching. I promise I'm not touching it. Yeah, and if your room has like more depth, of course, like unlike mine, then you kind of like also. There you go. So it kind of follows you. It's a stalker camera in the best way possible, right? So that is the price that's up for grabs tonight. And of course, like super high resolution, all that. I'll leave you to go Google this yourself. But thank you so much to our sponsors, Fullerton Hotel, as well as Jabra. Thank you so much for making this trivia night happen. All right, I'm going to go through some simple rules. There are 5 rounds tonight. There will be a short toilet break and intermission in the middle. Each of you, before we start, you're going to choose your joker round, and your joker round is what's going to double the points for you. Okay, so each question, if you get it right, you earn 1 point. And if that particular round is your joker round, all the points that you earn in that round will be doubled, okay? And there are 8 questions per round. At the start of each round, I will show you a QR code and you will scan in. One person from the team scan in, please. We don't want multiple submissions. And then you just have to key in all of your answers, like, you know, or select your answers. And then you click submit. It's a Google form, and Janet will be doing all the calculations in the back with her calculator and Abacus or whatever it is that she uses. And please submit the answer sheet whoops within the time limit. Black cat got my tongue there. And one answer sheet per team. I've already covered that, and we will be announcing best dress sometime after the intermission, okay, so that I can I kind of like need to look through, because I am apparently the judge for this one. So I'm going to look through and see, like, you know, who has put in some effort, and you're going to be earning extra points for your team. I would say 2 points for your team. Okay. All right. Now the rules, cameras on, please, as far as possible, because after all, we're here to network. I'll go around and ask all of you to introduce yourself in a bit. And please keep it mute while the game is going on, so that, you know, if Janet and I have anything important to share with you, you can follow. Absolutely no Googling or Alta Vistaing or searching on the internet, please, because that just spoils all the fun, right? Like, you know, I did a lot of Googling last night just to come out with these questions. The past couple of weeks. So, so try not to do it, because, like, you know, what would be the point, right? And of course, if there are any disputes, you can always let me know. Just unmute yourself and, like, you know, alert me, because I may not be able to see anything that you type in the chat when I'm sharing my screen. So just shout out and let me know if there are any disputes when we go through the question, the answers, okay? All right. I would like everyone to choose your joker round now and have a think about it. And in the meantime, can we just maybe go around the room to kind of like each team, maybe, you know, say something, introduce yourselves and your teammates, and, you know, who's playing today and what is it that you do? Because I guess most of us are from the media. So, you know, just we can just have like maybe 2 minutes to just go around the different teams. I'm going to call you out. Okay, so let's start with team S phase, stabilization phase.
Hello, hello.
Yes, that's us.
Hi. Okay, who's the team leader? Is it Juni? Is it Jinli? Is it Nick?
I think it's supposed to be me. I filled up the form by default, became me.
Okay, you want to say something to everyone? Just say hi or like and something, yeah, maybe something scary about your team.
A few of us have taken part in a few of these quizzes before, Nick and me, and then welcome to Jin Lee and Chong. And then Lily will be joining us after 8. She's speaking at some conference right now. But so, yes, that's us. Some of us are press club members. I'm a committee member, well, VP of the Singapore Press Club, and then Jin Lee is also on our management committee. So, yep. Welcome everyone, and yeah, this is I think our fourth trivia quiz. So,
oh, and that's why we will win.
I don't know any other questions, so I'm here to play, just like all of you. Welcome everyone. Okay, who's next?
Yeah, in case some of you don't know, this is an event brought to you by the Singapore Press Club. Okay, if you don't know that by now, shame on you. But you know, if you know that, like. Either way, we all know it now. So we'll give you more details if you want to sign up as a Press Club member in a bit, okay? Our next team, Team Tellum. I'm just going chronologically as I can see. Who is the team leader?
Is it Huishan?
I'm the one who outperformed, so by default, is it?
Hi, Huishan. Yes, yes. Tell us, yeah. You want to introduce, I mean, obviously I know you all quite well, but you yeah. can, you want, what yeah, about team everyone Tellum. Else?
So tonight we have team, we have George, Eugenia, and I, and also Hacker will be joining us soon, approximately 10 to 15 minutes, yeah. So we will enjoy tonight. We'll have fun.
Great. All right. And tell them, of course, like, you know, great guys, like I would know. And yeah, but I swear no favoritism going on tonight, right? They don't know the questions. They didn't know that this was happening, right? So good luck. All I can say is that I know Team Tellum came in fourth place the last round, and you all were just shy of the podium. So maybe this is a chance to redeem yourselves, okay? And you have more brains and hands on deck. I say okay, hands because,
they
again,
they started the first quiz as the last, and then they progress upwards. So each time they improved.
Yes, yes. Hashtag most improved. <Yeah. laughs> So we shall see. All right. Thank you so much, Team Tellum. We're going on to Spur Winging It. Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
We're from Spurwing. We're in different locations. But yes, we're a healthcare and food and nutrition PR agency here in Singapore. The last time we did this, we were second last, so very respectable. the scariest thing about us is we are the ones sending you all the pitch emails. So watch out for us.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is truly quite scary. But and good job on not coming in last, you know, the previous time. But I'm pretty sure with more experience, you came in the previous round, the golden trivia round session.
Was think it that? So. Think so. It was a while ago. So we'll see.
Okay.
We're aiming for team stabilization phase today.
Bring it on, man.
Ooh, wow. Some friendly rivalry already, like, you know, in the works right there. All right. Thank you so much, Spur Winging It. All the best of luck. Let's see who else is next. I see Zeno Thing. Are y'all still in separate teams? Okay, let's have Zeno Thing 1. I see Joanne nodding her head. Mm-hmm. Oh, where? Are
Hi.
You
there?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, so there's two teams because we're that excited. But we are going to be honest. That we will not Google, and we are excited to be here. We've not joined a single trivia before because we weren't invited previously, but it's okay, we're here now. Also, Zeno is a PR/creative/digital agency, and we work on really fun accounts. We've got tech, we've got hotels, we've got furniture. Yeah, that's us.
Okay,
furniture. Yeah, awesome. All right, Zeno Thing 2. Why is it that you don't want to be on the same team as Zeno Thing 1? Please tell us.
That's under Deborah.
Deborah. Paging Deborah.
Her mic is not working very well, so I will play Deborah for a while, my Halloween costume. So the reason why we're in a separate team because we want to maximize our chances. That is the truth. Yeah.
You just wanna make it on the podium, right? Is that what's happening?
Yes. Okay.
Wow. Someone's playing strategy. I love that. All right, good luck, Zeno 1 and Zeno 2. I love the little, and I love how you all came prepared with your backgrounds as well. And I can see some of the Minnie Mouse outfits also through the background. So thank you so much for putting in the effort. Ookie Cookie, over to you guys. I only see one person. Is that Isaac?
The all-in-one.
Oh, they have to unmute. Yeah. Can you just give us a lowdown of who you are and like...
Hi.
Yes, hi.
We are here to play this trivia thing. I don't know. I just got the like link about 5 minutes ago and someone said just participate in this. So we were like, okay, sure. So I'm here.
Okay, I feel like that's not...
That's a lie. You got the link today, okay?
Yeah, you see, that is a lie. That is a lie. All right. Something's going on my PowerPoint, but please ignore it in the meantime. I'm just gonna go to Raduga Peeps. Raduga Peeps, say hi.
Hi.
Hi, we are Raduga Peeps. We are a mixture of Ogilvy and Parkway Health. So we are covering health and advertising. We are in different locations. So we have Liz, who's actually working hard in the office, and Vanessa, who's in a wonderful sushi costume. Hint, hint, Vanessa, if you like to show yourself. And both of us. You can see her. I think she's missing a block of wasabi, which actually is right nearby. So I see.
Oh, she is sushi. No. And that's why she has chopsticks in her hair.
Yeah.
I see.
She's a sushi with wasabi. So yeah, this is actually our very first quiz that we're joining. Very glad to meet you all. And yeah, we can't wait to have fun.
Sorry, wait. But Vanessa is the one who's in the office.
Liz is the one that's in the office.
Oh, sorry. Okay. I thought she was the one working hard in the office and she transformed herself into a sushi.
No. Liz is in the office and Vanessa is working hard from her home office. Yeah.
Also, just okay.
Thank you, team. Thank you, team Raduga. And thank you, Vanessa, in particular for making us all hungry. All right. Okay, I think we've gone all around. Have I missed anyone out? No, right?
Yeah, all done.
Okay, I know some people like Heiko are coming in a bit, but Team Tellum, I'm sure you'll just like, you know, he'll catch right up. Okay, have we chosen a joker round? So I need to go back and it's not allowing me to do that. I need to stop this share again because I fear that you will see the questions. The first round is... Sorry? Can I just have each of you, one person... Someone was trying to say something?
We choose ours as scary screens.
Okay, yeah. Can we all choose the joker rounds now? And if you can do what Okie Cookie did and type it into the chat so Janet can have a physical record of it, okay? So Okie Cookie has chosen scary screens as the joker. Do you all need the rest of the rounds? I'm going to share it in a bit. Just 1 second. Okay. Perfect. Present. Can y'all see? Okay. Joke around now. Occult origins, it's about history. Scary screens is about movies. Spooky sounds, music. The fourth round is math plus media equals to magic. That is the one that we all need our calculators. Or maybe you don't, like, okay. But don't worry, nothing to do with like differentiation or like integration or whatever. Okay, nothing too impossible. And curious costumes, which is about celebrities, that will be the last round. So can I please have all the teams type in their chosen joker round? Remember, this joker round will earn you double the points. So however many points, the maximum you can earn in one round is the 8 questions. So 8 points. And then if that is your joker round, the maximum you can earn is 16 points, which will put you right ahead of everyone else. All right. Xeno Thing 1, Xeno Thing 2, Raduga Peeps, Team Tellum, for winging it. Okay, Cookie. I'm waiting for stabilization phase. Y'all haven't chosen anything yet, right?
We did. Oh, you have? Okay. The chat. Yeah.
Okay, movies. Thank you. Okay, going for scary screens. Janet, we're all good?
Okay, checking.
Okay.
It's okay, you can proceed. I can look at the chats.
Okay, so... All right, awesome. Okay, we're going to start with the first round. So can I just get you all to prepare one team, prepare one phone and scan into this QR code, please. This will lead you to a Google form that will allow you to access basically the answer sheet, all right? And the answers, so the questions will appear here on my PowerPoint. And using the Google form, please key in the relevant answers, okay? Or what you think are the right answers. Okay, and give me a shout out when everyone's ready. Is everyone ready?
Yes, we're ready. Woo!
All right, okay, I know most of you are mute, so I'm just gonna imagine that all of you are really excited right now. Okay, I can see some arms in the air. That's awesome, that's awesome. Okay, all scan in, yeah? Please, only one form submission per team, okay? No multiple submissions, because that will create confusion in the back. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead. If there are any objections, please let it be known now. I'm gonna go to the first question of round one. First question of round one, are we ready? Okay, let's go. This is an MCQ round, okay? So, Halloween, also known as All Hallows Eve or All Saints Eve, is believed to have originated from an ancient what festival? Is it A, Anglo-Saxon, B, Celtic, C, Greek, or D, Roman? All right. Question two. Black and orange are the colors most commonly associated with Halloween, with black representing darkness and death. What does orange symbolize when it comes to Halloween? What does orange symbolize? Angels and saints, autumn and harvest, Salem, or pumpkins? All right, question three. Apple bobbing or apple ducking is a Halloween game where players try to catch apples floating on water with their teeth. Which deity are the apples believed to represent? Which deity? Is it A, Pomona, B, Persephone, C, Gaia, or D, Demeter? All right, so if you like apples, maybe you know this one. I'm going to go a bit quicker. And if we need to revisit any of these questions, just let me know at the end of this round, okay? Okay. The Halloween tradition of wearing costumes began when people wore masks to avoid what? The plague, the devil, ghosts, or witches? My bad. I just lost us question four. Oh, there we go. The Halloween tradition of wearing costumes began when people wore masks to avoid what? Is it A, B, C, or D? Okay. Okay. I'm going to move on to our next question, which you kind of got a glimpse of. On to superstition. It's considered good luck to see this animal on Halloween because it means that the spirit of a loved one is watching over you. If you see this animal on Halloween, is it a spider? Could it be a bat? Might it be a cat? Or perhaps it's an owl? Spider, bat, cat, owl. All right, next question. Whoops. Question six. Jack-o'-lanterns come from a folklore about a farmer named Jack, who tricked the devil and was banned from both heaven and hell. While wandering around in purgatory, Jack fashioned a lantern out of which vegetable or fruit? Which vegetable or fruit, okay, did this lantern come from? Melon, potato, turnip, or pumpkin? Once again, just a gentle reminder, if you're using your phones, it's only to key in the answers, okay? Please no searching. Like, you know, trust me, I will share the answers with you right after this round and we'll all be the wiser for it, okay? Next question. One Halloween custom has people knocking on doors in costume and asking for gifts like money or food. Depending on your location, this practice goes by the following names, except what does it not go by? Trick-or-treating, shrouding, souling, or guising? Okay, are we all good with the questions? All right, question 8, this is the last question. So onophobia refers to a fear of all things Halloween. What does the root word? Swan, I think that's how it's pronounced. What does the root word mean? Okay. Dawn of the Dead, Feast of All Saints, Burning of Witches, or the End of Summer?
Sound,
that's how you pronounce it. My bad. That's what I was trying to Google.
Sound.
That's how you pronounce it. Soundophobia, all right, refers to a fear of all things Halloween. What does the root word sound mean? Okay, everyone good? Does anyone need me to revisit any of the questions? Please unmute yourselves now and let me know.
Can we revisit question one, please?
Thank you.
Question one, okay, any other questions? This is question one. Did Halloween come from an Anglo-Saxon festival, or was it Celtic, or was it Greek, or perhaps it was Roman? Any other questions that need repeating? If not, please submit your answers now.
Can we have question 8, please?
Can you actually just quickly go through everything again so just we make sure that you got the options, because there's a lot of like commotion going on.
Right. Okay. Okie cookie is, yeah. All right. Sure. Let's do that. So I think we've gone through question one again, and I heard someone ask for question 8. So we'll get to question 8. Let's go through all of it real quick, but I'm not going to read it out. Okay. Just in the interest of time. So this is question 1, from an ancient what festival? Question 2, what does orange symbolize? Question 3, apples, who do these apples represent? Who do they represent? Question 4, people wore masks to avoid what? Not COVID, but back in the day, what did they wear masks to avoid? Okay. And moving on to question 5. According to Halloween superstition, the spirit of a loved one is watching over you when you see this animal. What animal is this? And the jack-o'-lantern. Jack, basically. Jack, the farmer in this folklore. By the way, the phrasing of the question is very important, okay? So I'm asking about Jack in particular. What did he fashion the lantern out of? Okay. No more clues. This Halloween custom goes by all these names except one of them, which is the odd one out, which one does not apply. And question 8. Swanophobia refers to a fear of all things Halloween. What does the root word swan mean? Dawn of the Dead, Feast of All Saints, Burning of Witches, the End of Summer. All right. Fun, right? These questions. I learned so much like researching them. Janet, do we have all the answers in?
No, according to 4 teams.
Only four teams have submitted. Okay, please, can we have the answers in 30 seconds? Okay, I'm going to time it right now. All right, don't mind the deafening silence, all right? Okay, because I just wanted to make sure that you can all hear the questions properly and there's no, and if anyone wants to speak out, then you don't get drowned out. Okay, 30 seconds are up. Janet, do we have all the teams in? Who is, or who hasn't submitted yet, then?
Okay, last one, stabilization came in, okay.
All right, stabilizing round one for us. Okay, well, Janet compiles all of your answers and collates the results. We are going to go through the answers. Okay, so this is when you can unmute yourself and feel free to have fun with this. Okay, chime in if you think you are very confident of your answers. Let me know, okay? Oh, yes! Wow. There was no surprise. Yeah, it's Celtic. It's Celtic. Did anyone guess otherwise? And do you want to dispute this answer? No?
It's definitely correct because we chose this one.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I agree.
It's too late to change your answers, yeah? Okay, Spur winging it. Did you manage to wing this? No? Oh, okay. It's okay. Better luck next time. Next question. Black and orange. What does orange symbolize? Anyone want to guess?
B. I'm assuming it's B.
Autumn and harvest.
Wu Chong said B, is it?
Yeah, I'm assuming it's B.
You're right. So apparently Halloween was very much a harvest, Celtic harvest festival. Okay, so that kind of like explains both questions one and two right now, the answers behind that. So they're celebrating the harvest that comes in autumn. Okay, apple bobbing. I think this is a very more American game, if I'm not wrong, or maybe even in the UK, but I'm not sure if we do it so much here in Singapore. But yeah, it's really fun, and you know, because people look ridiculous, and we all love it when our friends look ridiculous. Which deity are the apples believed to represent? Anyone want to answer? Does anyone think they know the answer? No?
I think we chose D, but now I'm feeling that it might be B.
You chose Demeter instead of Persephone, okay.
Just like partying, you know?
right. Well, all of these
now
goddesses.
That I'm thinking about it.
Right. Most of these are goddesses of, like, you know, harvest and fruit and everything, but in particular, Pomona is the one who represents fruit and harvest. But my PowerPoint is lagging again. Yeah, there we go. Persephone was a trick because she holds a pomegranate and not apple, right? Okay. So anyway, if you know your Roman and Greek gods, then this would be a fun one. If not, well, now you know.
What uni did you go to, Sam Jo?
Sorry?
What uni did you go to?
Who asked that?
Pomona College.
Yeah.
Yes. We should have known.
So that's, yes, exactly. That's a very vested interest. So Pomona, also a name of a very good college in Southern California. All right. Halloween, the tradition started with people wearing masks to avoid what? It is ghosts. Not any of the above, okay? Not anything else, I mean, like, but ghosts, as Ella Henderson would say. All right. Now, question five. According to superstition, this animal means the spirit of a loved one is watching over you on Halloween, particularly. Which one?
Owl.
Why do you say owl, Jilly?
Because everyone else in my team said owl.
Okay, stabilization phase is wrong. Anyone else had a different answer? I don't know. Xeno thing one. Do you have a different answer?
Come be spider, right? A spider is so small, look at you, wouldn't know also.
Well, unfortunately, Jin Lee, for you, it's a spider.
Wow. that comes back. I have like, what? Really?
Yeah.
No wonder nobody knows.
So the next time you think of taking out that broom to, like, you know, chase away that spider or to, you know, or insecticide, please think again, okay? Because it might just be good luck. All right, question six. Jack-o'-lanterns came up from a folklore. Now, this is actually a trick question. Yeah. I know most of you would, I'm not even gonna bother to ask, but I see even Tim's backdrop is like, you know, a couple of jack-o'-lanterns made from the pumpkin. And that is how we traditionally know it as now, or commonly know it as now. But apparently the first jack-o'-lanterns, or in the original jack-o'-lantern in the folklore, was made out of a turnip. And again, my slides are lagging, but it will turn pink in a bit. But yeah, made of a turnip. And it was only, interestingly, the reason why it became a pumpkin was because when a lot of the Irish people, you know, because of the Irish potato famine, moved over to Northern America to flee from the famine. There weren't a lot of turnips in North America, basically. So they used the next best available thing, and that was the pumpkin. So that's why it's so popular right now as the pumpkin. But don't...
How is that possible? You know, the turnip and the pumpkin is so different.
Exactly. What do you know, right?
But I used to use a turnip when I was a kid. It's really hard to make a jack-o'-lantern out of a turnip. It's really hard.
Wait, Tim, so you actually knew that it was a turnip and
I used to use a turnip when I was a kid.
We don't really have
pumpkins growing in the UK.
Yeah, so it's really a location thing. Okay, well, anyway, that's cool. All right. Following names, except, of course, we all know it most famously as trick-or-treating. It is also known as souling and guising. So shrouding is not what it is, yes. Even though it looks like, you know, if you're shrouding yourself in a costume, but that was a trick. Okay? So shrouding is the answer. And question eight, the one, I hope I'm pronouncing it correct. It's a Celtic word, so I'm trying to do it justice. But... Dawn of the Dead is a movie, so it's not that. It's not Feast of All Saints. That is Anne Rice's book. It's The End of Summer. Again, back to autumn and harvest. Okay? All right. So I hope you enjoyed that round. Janet's going to tabulate the scores. And in the meantime, we can all log on to question two. Okay, Scary Screens. This is the movie round. It's not going to be that tricky. I think this one is one of those things like, you know, you either know or you don't know. Okay. I'm going to give you some visuals. So I think, stabilization phase, you chose this as your joke around.
Yes. I believe someone else did as well.
Yeah. Xeno Thing One, Tim Tellum and Uki Kuki as well.
All right. Wow. So that's a lot. Okay. Well, good luck. I hope you know your movies and I hope you know your scary movies. Or in particular, Halloween-related movies, okay? Halloween or horror movies. Has everyone logged on has everyone scanned the QR code and arrived at a Google form? Okay. I don't hear any objections, so I'm going to move on. Name these. I need you to key in now. The Google form, you will see like short answer fields. Other than your team name, please key in the names of these horror, classic horror or Halloween films, okay? I'm going to be showing you stills from the movies, and you're just going to have to guess what these films are, okay? The title and the name of these films, okay? Every word has to be accurate, all right? Let's go. The first one. Okay, second. A bit slow, it's the computer doing things, okay? I'm trying to move on to the second slide. It's not happening. I'm sorry if this first movie traumatized many of you as well, because it definitely traumatized me as a kid. Oops. Well, this is question three. This is not question two. Okay, question two. This is movie two, okay? So let's go back to movie two for a bit. We see a little boat. We see some rain going on. Question three, as we saw, film three. something with an eye on it. And movie 4. This is number 4. Number 5. This one also kind of freaked me out, I must say.
Can you show number 4 again? Sam, sorry, too fast, cannot see.
I will go through all of it again in a bit, okay. Jin, yeah. Don't worry. Okay, this is 5. And then we have 6. And then we have 7. My heart wants to move forward, but my computer is saying no.
Computer.
I think there's a spirit down there next to you.
Yo, don't say that. Okay, now it's 7. Do not say that. I'm hiding from it now. I'm hiding from it. You cannot see me. Okay. Because technically I'm a werewolf, right? Okay, this is number 7. And of course, our final movie. Movie 8. Okay. So it's one of those things, if you know, you know. If you don't know, look for clues in the picture. Okay. There are plenty of clues. I try to pick scenes where they're enough. So if there are words, you could read them and everything. Okay. Should we try to go through all the movies again?
Yes.
Okay,
yes, please.
All right, let's do that. I'm going back to 1. This is the first one, first movie. And the second movie. Third movie. Fourth. Fifth. I'm trying to move on to the 6th, but it's kind of like forcing me to stay on 5. This is kind of scary. Maybe Jin is right. Oh my God. Okay, 6. All right. If we're good, I'm going to move on to 7. 7. And last but not least, 8. Okay, please submit all of your answers right now. Janet, how many people have submitted so far?
Okay, let me check.
Okay.
One, two, three, four, five, six. One team is missing. Xeno Thing 2.
Okay, Xeno Thing 2, please.
Okay, done. All 7.
Awesome. Okay, okay.
Now's my time.
Okay, Janet's time. All right, I'm going to go through the questions, the answers really quickly with everyone. Okay, so feel free to unmute yourselves and discuss. Okay, I think we all know this one, yeah? Anyone guess?
I'm hoping it's the ring, but I don't know if you use the original name.
Right. So in this case, I provided for that. And I think that if you tell me it's the ring or Ringu, which is the original, I would accept both. But actually, this one is the ring, the remake in 2002. And you can tell because the well looks different. I unfortunately had to Google these images late at night. So I would not recommend that at all. Yeah, so I kind of know, like, basically the original Ringu didn't have the brick formation, kind of. It was more of like a clean cut.
I think so.
What?
Is it the American one?
Yeah, the American one.
I was thinking some people may guess the Japanese version, which is Ju-on, if I'm not wrong.
Ju-on is a completely different movie.
Different. Ju-on is a different one.
And Ju-on is, Ju-on is Korean, no?
Yeah.
Okay.
Anyway, I'm afraid of horror movies. I never watched this. but I remember people said, there's this show, some woman will get out of the well and call the ring.
Yeah, exactly. And not only that, she crawls out of the TV into your room. So yeah.
Tabaco,
yeah. I don't know why my parents allowed me to watch that when I was 12 years old.
Same.
Right. Eugenia, is it?
Yeah.
And then, like, we have never been the same ever since, you know?
Yeah,
which really explains this.
This explains a lot about both of you.
Yeah. Exactly. Enough said. Okay, question two. The clue is really Georgie, because that is obviously the little boy, unfortunately, who, spoiler alert, something bad happens to him in It, okay? This particular one comes from, the year doesn't matter. I know that, you know, there have been many iterations of this movie, ha ha ha. But as long as you have the movie name right, okay, we'll give it to you. I'm seeing something in the chat, original or remake. Yeah, Nicholas, yeah. Nick, it doesn't matter, okay, as long as you get the name right.
As long as we get the marks, man.
As long as you get the marks, exactly. Okay. Question three, I have a feeling that Okie Cookie and Spur Winging It definitely know this. I don't know, I'm seeing them celebrate a bit. No?
Is it Evil Dead?
Wait, who said Evil Dead?
We guessed Evil Dead.
Really? Okay. No, it's actually Winifred Sanderson's Spell of Books in Hocus Pocus.
Yeah, no way to get that. I have no
right.
idea.
Well, it's not so much scary as it is like a family Halloween film. My presentation is lagging again, but it was supposed to dramatically present. There you go. A 1993 movie, okay, with Bette Midler, Kathleen the Jimmy, and Sarah Jessica Parker. So
I actually watched this one because it wasn't scary.
Yeah, it's actually kid-friendly, unlike The Ring. So yeah, if you don't want your kids to turn out like Eugenia and me, please have them watch Hocus Pocus instead of The Ring, instead of Ringu, okay? Yeah, but this is a really fun film, one of my favorites of all time. Okay, the next question was lagging again. I don't know why, I don't dare to do too much to it, but do you remember what question four was? Well, I said the questions and I'm forgetting. Sorry about that. Please, by the way, I hope you have refreshments on standby and everything. Okay. All right. Yes. I think this is quite obvious. Like, you know, it's one of the more famous films by Tim Burton. Nightmare Before Christmas. Also same year. And the big clue being the Santa Claus on the left. Okay. Next one. Does anyone know what this one is? Because I feel like it was a bit tricky, but it's one of my favorite films of all time as well. Also kid-friendly.
Is it Hansel and Gretel?
No, it's not Hansel and Gretel. Did anyone get this right?
Christmas Carol?
Christmas Carol? No?
It's not okay. Coraline, right?
Sorry?
Not Coraline, right?
No. Okay, wow. I didn't think it would be so hard. So this is actually a kid-friendly film. But this scene in particular was very scary because this was when it was revealed that the witch had trapped this little girl in the picture.
Oh.
In The Witches, 1990. Okay, starring Angelica Houston.
Yeah, I thought it was this one. I wasn't sure.
Yeah, Angelica Houston as the Grand High Witch. Okay, so there was the grandmother was telling a story of how she was a little girl and she knew this other little girl who was captured by a witch and was forced to live the rest of her life in this picture until she died. It's very, very freaky.
They did a remake recently on HBO, the new one.
Yeah, with Anne Hathaway.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Octavia Spencer. Very, very good movie. I would highly recommend it. Yes, yeah. Yes. If you don't want to traumatize your kids. So again, if you don't want your kids to turn out like Eugenia and me, Eugenia, I'm sorry, I'm using your name in vain. Please let them watch The Witches and not Ringu. Okay. All right. This, does anyone know? It's from a very... Yeah, correct. It's from the scene... Sorry?
Quiet, please.
Exactly. Okay, quite a few of you got it. Yeah, this is the poor little boy who, you know, they're supposed to be very quiet until, you know... lest the monster gets them, right? And so he kind of like turned on this little toy and it kind of like attacked him. So this is from A Quiet Place.
How scary is this show? Is this a scary show?
Quite scary.
Scary, yeah. Okay, I will watch it then.
I didn't find it scary. It's not as scary as The Ring. I think that it's, if you ask, you know, it's mostly quiet. So if you're uncomfortable with silence, then don't watch it.
It's 16 years before this, you were traumatized watching The Ring. Nothing is scary anymore.
You think? It like the damage stays with you. Like
Actually, I was traumatized by Omen.
Oh, yeah. Me too, man. Old school.
Exorcist. Yeah, Omen, Exorcist. But yeah, I love watching horror movies now.
Yeah, Shutter, like, you know. George, you say the episode of Charm is scary nonsense. I know George is a huge Charm fan, so yeah. Okay, this one, it's a classic Hitchcock Psycho. We all know what happens in the shower, and if you don't know, I'm not going to spoil it for you, but it's pretty exciting. It's pretty exciting. So... yeah, you may, if you haven't taken a shower yet, good luck. Okay, question 8. Again, it's lagging on me. It's not that I'm being slow. Yeah. All right. I think you know this. You can see blood. You can see the train. You can see some Korean word. Sorry?
Busan, train to Busan.
Yes, is that Zeno? I don't know who's talking actually.
Raduga.
Oh, Raduga. Sorry, Raduga. Yes, Raduga peeps. Train to Busan from 2016. And this is the baseball player, right? There was a team of baseball players who were on the train with them and he was trying to whack a zombie. Okay. Anyway, no more spoilers. I'm guessing all of us here are borderline horror fans, but we are on to our next round, which is spooky sounds. And please scan in to this in the meantime if you haven't already. And I'm trying to play some... don't mind me. I'm just going to play some music in the back and I'm going to see... oh, no, I can't play music for this round. I'll just try it later, okay? Okay. Has anyone scanned in? If you have, I'm going to move on to the next round. Okay, okay, Cookie, I see your thumbs up. How's everyone else doing?
Welcome, Lily.
Sorry?
Welcome, Lily.
Oh, hi, Lily.
Hey, Lily's here. She's in our team.
Yeah. Hi, Lily. Thanks for joining. You it's missed some a couple of fun rounds, but you're in time for the music. Okay.
Yeah.
So I will not keep you all waiting any longer. And I'm just going to go in. Okay, everyone, no objections. I'm going to move on to question 1. Okay.
Okay, Joker round for Zeno Thing 2.
All right, Zeno Thing 2. This is your moment to shine. I really hope you know your songs well, because if you do, this is your chance to get 16 points in one shot. Okay, let's go. I'm going to play some spooky songs for all of you. And when I say spooky, they're not necessarily scary, but they are surrounding the theme of like the supernatural and or Halloween, okay, in terms of their song title or their lyrics or the artist who sang them. So in your question... in your answer form, you will see that, you know, you have to key in the artist. So I want to know who, okay? I want to know either the singer or the band that sang this, okay? So I'm not interested in the name of the song. I want to know who. And some songs have multiple versions and multiple renditions. I want to know this particular one that I'm playing, okay? Justin Bieber is scary, I just saw it. To some people, yeah. Okay, well, how do you know? Because the first song is Baby. No, I'm kidding. Okay, I'm going to play the first song. Let me know if you have any trouble hearing this, okay? Okay, that was song one. I need to know who sang this version, okay? I'm going to go on to song two. We'll revisit the songs one more time after this, okay? So fret not, we'll move on. Question two. Okay, but who sang the song? Okay. Moving on, question three, or song three, rather. It's lagging again. Okay, I'm sure some of us in the crowd would have loved that, but I'm not gonna spoil it for now. All right, question four, song number four, who sang this? Okay, and song number five goes like this. Okay, now question six.
Hey, that's my favorite karaoke song.
Really? Janet, we need, okay, so Janet, after this, is gonna do a performance for us. All right.
No.
During the intermission. Really?
Yeah.
Wow. So I want to get a vote, a show of hands, but I'm pretty sure everyone's going to say yes. We want to see you. We want to hear you at least do a little bit, okay? Okay, we're not going to spoil it yet, but song number seven. Okay. And last one. Okay, here we go. Sometimes vocabulary runs through my head. The alphabet runs right from A to Z. Conversations, hesitations in my mind. You got my conscience asking questions that I can't find. All right. Do we need to hear the songs again? I think we do, yeah? Just hey, one.
Do you want the name of the singer or the song title?
Singer, please, Jin.
Oh, singer, okay.
Yeah.
So no need song title, huh?
No, I do not want a song title. That's why in the answer form it says artist 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Only the artist. So either the singer, if it's a solo singer, if you think it's a solo singer, or the band, okay?
All right.
Okay.
Let's hear it again.
And the last clue, I will play all for you again. And the last clue being, just to throw a clue in, like if you are having trouble guessing, either the song or the lyrics or the artist have something to do with horror and Halloween, okay? Either the song, the lyric, or the artist, okay? We'll show you the answers, but let's hear song one again. I'm just going to go through all of them one last time, and this is your last chance. Okay, at the end of song eight, please submit all of your answers to Janet. Okay, let's go. Song one. Oh, Okay, very soulful rendition there. Song number two. All right, song number three. Song four. When it decides to show up. I love how Tim's background has been regularly, like, you know, on this kind of like, what do you call that? Like carousel. He's just switching between his different scary backgrounds. Okay, who sang that, okay? Question five. Okay, here we go. Okay. All right, question six. Very famous guitar riff right there, okay? We're on the seven, song number seven. Who sang this? And last one. All right. Please submit all of your forms. Janet, all in? If not...
Nope.
Okay, how many more teams? Can we give you all half a minute?
Okay, all in.
All in. Awesome. Thank you so much. Okay, I just
Do we actually get an update on where we are right now?
Give me a minute. I need to score this one first.
Yeah, not yet. Okay.
It just came in, right?
Yeah. We will have updates in a bit, but we will have an intermission, so we can kind of give an update. How about that? How about after halftime, okay? So this is our last round before our break. So let's just, I'm going to share the answers with you right now. If my slides decide to actually respond. Paging the pumpkin. It's not 12 a.m. yet. Like, hello. Okay, well, okay. So this is the song. We just heard it. Question one, song number one, anyone want to guess? Oh, it's the one that went like that. Yeah, it's I Put a Spell on You, and who sang it?
Nina Simone.
Very good, Nina Simone. So quite a lot of people have covered this, like from Annie Lennox to Bette Midler, but Nina Simone really, I feel like, you know, did this one justice. Okay. So Nina Simone is the answer. If you put anyone else, I'm sorry, it's wrong because the question asked for the artist who sang this particular rendition, okay? All right. Zeno, Thing 2, they look very scared because they're like, oh no, my hour joke around. Like, you get this wrong? You did that, like, okay. Deborah's nodding. She's like, oh no, okay. It's okay. Maybe you got question two right. I think we all know that this is this song, yeah? But maybe you forgot his name. His name is Ray Parker Jr. Yeah, okay. So anyway, songs to revisit this weekend, for sure. It's one of those things that just keep, like, you know, one day I wake up and I remember, oh, this song exists, and I play it on Spotify, and I go, yes. So that was me this morning. Okay, and that's why I had to put it in the quiz. All right. I want to hear from George, paging George. What song? Who sang this song?
There are many versions of it, but we put Love Spit Love.
Because?
From Charmed, it's more popularly used on Charmed.
Yes, it was the theme song of Charmed, but also some people may know this, but before it was used in Charmed, it was actually used on the soundtrack of The Craft. So it was the Love Spit Love version, yes. Also a film about witches. So a very strong association with witches, which is why it has its, like, you know, which is why it found its way into our little Halloween trivia quiz tonight. All right. A very good movie. They also did a remake of this movie recently. Not bad. Like, go check it out if you have time. All right. I'm seeing someone typing in the chat. What happens if we didn't add Junior for Ray Parker? Xeno Thing One.
Okay.
I'm going to give you half a point. I'm going to give... Janet, I'm going to give... Let's give Xeno Thing One half a point if you didn't add Junior. They just got Ray Parker. If they did... at Ray Parker, because I think it's quite amazing that you even remember him.
So half point, eh? Okay.
Half point, yeah. But I have to penalize them because Ray Parker is his dad. You know what I'm trying to say? So I didn't ask for his daddy. I asked for the son. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. No Junior, no dice. Alyssa Milano, teenhood crush. Heiko, fun fact. Yeah, wasn't Ray Parker senior. Tim says, Heiko, do you know that I'm not sure if you know this, but do you know that Ariel from The Little Mermaid was actually, like, the Disney version was actually modeled after Alyssa Milano?
Yes, I actually do know that.
So she really...
I saw this on a trivia a few years back.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, do you still have her poster, her pinup somewhere in your room?
I don't know. It would be quite scary, right?
You never know. Yeah, but yeah, that's where she was the basis of that. Yeah. And so, and I, interestingly, I have a friend whose name is Ariel and her brother, you know, whose name is Alyssa and her brother is Ariel.
Oh.
So yeah, parents really love Little Mermaid right there. Okay. Another trivia that you didn't ask for. Anyway, moving on to song number four. Right. This one with a lot of like, ooh, howling and everything. That wasn't me. That was actually Michael Jackson in Thriller. I think most of us got that right. I'm hoping. I purposely did 100%. Okay. Mm. That's easy. It is the classic Halloween song. Okay. This one I think is a little bit tricky, but if you were, you know, very... If you were tuning in a lot to music in the mid-2000s, you would know of this little band called Blue October, and they sang this song called Hate Me. Yeah, and the first two words of the chorus, Hate Me, can be heard in the last part of that snippet. So yeah, this is just a little tricky one. Again, you know, song titles, but also artist name, right? October, because it is October. All right, question six, we have... Are they crawling on a brain? I hope they are. Okay, anyway, just a thought. I think we all know this one. I'm going to go to Raduga Peeps. What do you think this song is?
Zombie.
Wow, you want to perform for... We have so many singers, so we need... Kara is a really good singer, by the way. So you are absolutely right. It was Zombie by The Cranberries. So... If you put The Cranberries, I'll mark you right. But technically, I did ask for who sang it. So if you also listed the late Dolores O'Riordan, like, I will also give you the point, okay? Because, yeah, she sang it and she's amazing and she's irreplaceable. So rest in peace, Dolores. We're thinking of you. All right. Enough of me being a Cranberries fan right here. Song number seven. Anyone know this one? This one, I think, is a tough one.
Smashing Pumpkins.
What? Easy?
Smashing Pumpkins.
Pumpkins.
How do you guess?
1979.
Correct, 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 correct. Okay, I think it's, yeah, okay. Nick and Heiko, both of your era. Like,
yeah. So
you know. Were you born 1979?
Unfortunately, no.
Okay.
A lot younger than that.
Yeah, a few years shy of that, yeah. Anyone here born in 1979? Don't dare to say no. That's right. No, I'm kidding. But anyway, yeah. If you know it, you know it. Yeah. Okay. It's a great song. All these great songs to revisit. And last song in our catalog for tonight. As in when it loads, stop flaunting your youth. Oh no, I'm not. I'm not too far off. I promise you. I promise you. In fact, if anything, these songs betray my age. Okay, this one is a bit of a trick, but as we all know from round one, Halloween is also known as All Saints Eve, and therefore I had to put in an All Saints song. And the woman that you heard like belting her heart out there was Shazne Lewis, right in the middle, who wrote many of their songs as well. An awesome band, also from the UK. Go check them out if you haven't already. And that brings us to the end of this round. It is a toilet break time. We are going to tabulate all your scores and give you a halftime score. But please, let's all take 5 minutes. So I, on my clock right now, it's 8:19.
You want me to show?
Oh, do you have the scores? Yeah, okay, sure. So whoever wants to go toilet, go toilet. But in the meantime, let's please share the scores. I'm going to stop sharing and let Janet take over. And maybe I'll play some music. Jenna, are you sharing? Oh, yeah, you are.
Okay, can see?
Yes.
Too small, him.
Too small? Okay,
just about.
Can y'all see? Can you hear me, by the way?
Yes, we can.
Okay, I'm just hearing, I'm just playing some atmospheric music, so let me know if it's like too intrusive or whatever. But yeah, so I think right now it's quite clear that in the lead at the halftime score, we have Ookie Cookie at 28, and they haven't, only they already used their Joker round, that's why they got 16 in round two. Okay, but not trailing, not very far behind at a tie. A Team Talon, man. Team Zero, thank you. I'm very happy. Team Talon, this might just be a chance to make the podium. All right. Led by Hui Shan, no less. So good job, good job. Maybe you can edge out Zeno thing. I don't know. We'll see. But both of you have already used your Joker rounds, I see. So maybe the rest of you can catch up as well, because stabilization phase is not far behind, followed by Zeno Thing 1, Raduga Peeps, and Spur winging it. Okay.
Well, Raduga Peeps and Spurring haven't used yet.
Exactly. They may be at the bottom of the charts, but they are not out of the game yet, because they haven't used their, they haven't exercised their Joker round. So we'll see. Okay, let's give everyone like maybe like 3 more minutes. No one needs to take a number two, I'm guessing. So how about we come back at 8:25, okay? Just for a short toilet break. And if you wanna top up your refreshments or get some food, or maybe like, you know, fix your costume. Oh, by the way, we'll be announcing the best dress right after this. So stay tuned, okay? Okay, I'm gonna play some of the music that we heard just now. And we'll be back with you in just a bit. Thanks for joining us. And by the way, if there's any feedback or anything, please like message me, or you can also just type into the chat if you feel like the songs are like, you know, not to your liking or anything. Okay, but please go to the toilet. Okay, don't mind me. I can talk forever, you know. Okay. Okay, we play more upbeat music. Like you probably don't want something. Do we have any like song dedications or requests I can play? Maybe from the songs that we heard in round three. Anyone wants any preferences for the rest of us who don't have a weak bladder? And
I Put a Spell on You by Hocus Pocus.
Oh, so Spotify doesn't have the Hocus Pocus version for whatever reason. But you know what? Just for you, I'm gonna find it on YouTube. Because, like, you know, but we might have to bear the ads, right? Yeah, okay. Let me know if you can hear it.
Introducing Grammarly, a digital writing assistant that you can
do you hear that? Easily on your browser. Grammarly is here to haunt me. Okay, here we go. Enjoy. Enjoy the music. We'll be back.
I put a spell on you. And now you're mine. You can't stop the things I do. I ain't lying. In 300 years, right down to the day, now the witch is back, and there's hell to pay. I on you.
Good joke, Kakao. No, man, I'm serious.
That was it. Okay, I know it is time, but someone just asked me for extra time for best dress. So I'm going to give them the 2 minutes that they require. But when we come back, I'll play one more song. And when we come back, we will announce best dress. And whoever gets best dress will win. How many points for the team? 2 points. I think I said 2 points. And that might be the points that make all the difference. Okay. So I'm just going to play another song right now. Let's see what song do we want. Okay, a happy song, I guess.
Next.
guess. I'm free to make guess.
Hello. Okay, we're all back, I think. Hi. The song is really long, so I'm just conscious of, like, you know, the time, because I know I don't want to eat into your evenings. Because I could be here all night, you know, but let's go on to best dress. I'm going to share my screen again, and can we please have all of you?
Yes, yes, we are coming on screen. Just give us a sec.
Who is we? Wow, there are surprises. Okay, so... two points, very important for some teams that are really out to get this. Everyone wants the Fullerton
Hotels
video cam.
Quick drag!
I worry when everyone says that. Because it could turn out... either way. Okay, wait! Whoa! What is going on? Okay, I'm not sure. I don't think I have the rights to spotlight people, but can we please? Wait, Janet, are you here?
Yes, I'm here. Yes, I'm here.
Can we spotlight some people and then we kind of like... Yeah, we suddenly, Elsa came out of nowhere. Can we please spotlight Ookie Cookie? I'm interested in what they are serving us. What is going on? With the whole night, we didn't see them and then suddenly... Can we spotlight them?
Yeah, I spotlighted.
We spotlighted, sorry.
Can you all see? Yeah.
Yes, so hi Elsa. Elsa.
Hi.
Who are you? Elsa and who? What?
This Elsa, this is Neo from the Matrix.
Yeah. I'm Dorothy. I just had a haircut. So. Wait, and then we have Dill. Dill, come in. She's a polka dot man from Suicide Squad.
Polka dot man from Suicide Squad. Okay, so this is my squad. Yeah. Jinli, I'm afraid you have been outdressed. Okay. Can we spotlight spur winging it, please? Particularly the devil and the pirate and the mummy, I think. I don't know.
Okay.
Wow. I love all the effort. Suddenly, like, you know, you're here, you're gonna earn 2 points. And 2 points, by the way, sounds very little, but it could mean make or break if you've been to a previous trivia round. And also it's 1/4 of a whole round. So that's just 3 points we're giving, okay? Can we spotlight spur winging it? I just want everyone to see. No, I still see Jin Lee.
So spur wing actually just has to unmute themselves and speak. And then if you change your view to speaker view, they'll be on,
on the big screen. Everyone on speaker view and you can see them.
Hi.
Change your view to speaker view.
Awesome. Hi. Can you tell? Oh, wait, are you using a filter?
Using a filter.
So the center one is the filter, but we are both wearing like sunscreen.
Okay. All right, cool. I love it though, still. Thanks for the effort. Let's see who else is dressed up. I see Minnie Mouse. I see a nurse. Very nice. Tim, as we know, is a witch. Heiko is a pussycat doll. Kylie is a... Let's spotlight Kylie. She's been... It must be really warm. Can we spotlight Kylie from Xeno Thing 2? Because...
Sweaty unicorn.
Yeah. I say this as someone who's in my, like, full-on fur. Kylie, you need to unmute yourself and just say something for a while.
Then I have, like, 3 fans on me right now.
Right? And I see your ACs on.
Mm.
Yeah. I feel your pain because, like, this isn't warm. This is quite warm as well. So, And I love the glitter action. Thank you so much. Thanks for putting in the effort. We are going to like screenshot you for posterity. Okay, 1, 2, 3, smile. Okay, great. And who else is up for best dress? George, as we know, like it's serving Christmas. Oh, Lily Ong. Can we spotlight Lily Ong? Lily Ong is from Fae, not substitution.
Stabilization.
Stabilization phase.
Hey, don't tell me our name, eh.
Lily, and you unmute yourself and say something and we can pin you. But she is who is that? Is it Lily?
She's a royal vampire.
And I'm here to suck your blood.
You are what?
Suck your blood.
Wow, wow, wow. If that Lily Ong Parker Jr., everybody. Can you say something again? We're gonna like screenshot you just for again for posterity. Lily, what's your name, by the way?
She's a royal vampire.
And I'm here to suck your blood.
What's your name?
Say your name.
A vampire.
You have to tell them. They can't spotlight you unless you're talking.
Hi.
Say hi.
Hello.
Okay, thank you so much. All right, I think, and we also had our sushi just now, I think. Can we look at Van from Raduga Peeps, just the last one?
I think Van has been taking a work call, so I apologize on her behalf.
Like, she's working.
She's working hard.
She's working hard. Okay. Okay, well, anyway, it's the end of our break, but thank you so much for taking part, everyone. I really appreciate all your costumes. I'm just looking at Janet right now, and it's super funny, so I'm also going to screenshot her. Okay, we can send around these pictures later. Don't worry, I'm not being a creep, okay? But yeah, it's not often that we have people dress up for our event, so I'm just like appreciating this. Okay, I'm going to go also based on, I'm going to share my screen right now, and we're going to go into our next round. But before that, we're going to announce best dress. So can we please share the screen? If my computer decides to cooperate. Okay, here we go. Welcome back, everybody. I'm going to be playing like lo-fi music in the back in the meantime. So yeah. Can you hear that?
Yes.
Okay, good. So I just want to have it like low key and everything, okay? So that we, so that it's not so quiet. If you have problems hearing me at any point in time, just holler and let me know, okay? All right, 10 o'clock, toilet break over. I hope some of you got to do your number one, number two, number three. We're back. Meetup vs. PR Trivia Night presented by Singapore Press Club, Halloween edition, and thanks to our amazing sponsors, Jabra and Fullerton Hotel and Resort. Okay, all right, moving on to our best dress competition. We have been searching high and whoa, not yet. Whoa. Okay, best dress. So whoever's getting best dress will earn their team 2 points, okay? 2 points and I was discussing with Janet earlier during the halftime show and our own little halftime show. That was the halftime show. And we all have very, very strong contenders. So it's a very tough choice, but you know, all these amazing, freaky, beautiful looking people sit in front of me, but I only have one prize in my hand. And so I have to say, the best dress goes to it's having so much time, like all of you are great, but I have to give it to this is really tough, but I'm sorry. I have to give it to okay, me. I made up my mind.
Me.
No, Janet, it's not you. It's not you. I will stop stalling. I stand with my decision. I just love how sporting everyone was, but I stand with my decision, and I do think that the most creative costume today, everyone looks great. Don't get me wrong, but I think because she made the costume herself and she delivered an illusion. And she really, you know, even though it's not scary, but I feel like Halloween also is about, like we said earlier, hiding from the spirits. And I think she did a great job. So I'm going to give it to Vanessa. I'm going to give it to Vanessa from Raduga Peeps as the sushi. She's taking a work call right now, but she is, in my opinion, the best dress. Okay. If you have any objections with that,
they are undressing now.
Yeah, she will reveal herself in a bit, but wait, what? Oh, Okie Cookie is quitting. Yeah.
Undressing themselves.
I'm sorry, Okie Cookie. I think I've seen y'all in those costumes too many times. So, but maybe it's like, you know, a desensitized la. Yeah, the undressing is real. That is the real horror of the night. Okay. Okay, but Janet, so please take note. Zeno, thing two. Raduga Peeps. Raduga Peeps will get 2 bonus points, okay? Thank you to everyone else for dressing up really, really. Even Junie for putting a cushion on your head. I appreciate that. Yeah. And Lily Parker Jr., you are so adorable. And I believe you, you know, we'll give you some blood after this, okay? Thank you so much for joining us. Okay, let's move on to our next round. Let's scan into, well, sketch maybe if you need to like do rough work. By the way, if the music is too loud, let me know, okay? So I'm going to go into a mathematical round. It's about math and media and magic. It's all of those things. If you're not sure what that means, I will explain it in a bit. Have we all got into the form? All teams, if you're not in the form yet, please let me know. This is a really fun one because it will really require a lot of teamwork, I assure you, okay? Okay. Yes, calculator. Thank you, Lillian. I see your calculator. Very good. Okay, wow, and a scientific calculator. We don't need to go there, yeah? But because I also like Ringu, that traumatized me a lot, like math in school. So I'm not going to go there. Okay, we'll go into our first question. I hope there are no questions about Ivan and Helen. What do you mean? Is this a reference I'm not getting?
Wow, you've been
the
PSLE question.
Oh, that one. Right. No. Yeah. I have no excuse. But I will say it's been a while since I took PSLE, okay? So if Nick still thinks I'm flaunting my youth, well, there you go. Now, I want you all to solve these magical media mathematical questions, MMM equations, okay? I'm going to give you an example. These are kind of like a cross between cryptic crossword and math equations, okay? So here we go. This is an example, okay? Hopefully you don't look as confused as the cat. Okay, so a good example is this. Halloween day plus at the last minute, all the answers are numbers. So I need you to give me a number as the answer. Does anyone want to hazard a guess?
3011.
Okay, but we are plusing it.
Is it 31 plus 59, is it?
90.
31 plus 11? For last minute?
Right.
Last minute.
90.
Yeah. Okay, so just as a proof of concept, although I hear Nick saying 59, but it's the 11th, at the last minute means the 11th hour. So Halloween day is on the 31st, and not the month, but the day. And at the last minute means 11th hour. So essentially your answer should be 31 plus 11. And your answer should be?
49.
What?
42. There you go. See.
You should be going to the finance.
I worry for Teller.
That's the reason why I'm in the media and PR.
Yeah. And that's the reason why I chose to do math. Because trust me, that was my least favorite subject in school, but I figured we could all do with a little challenge, okay? And yeah, so, but really grab your drinks, your companions, your calculators, because you're going to be in for a ride. Okay, everyone's in the form. No objections. I'm going to go to question one, or rather equation one. Accursed Friday plus Mr. Carter's problems. Again, it's cryptic. So each of these phrases represents a number. I need you to plus, to add two of these numbers together to give me your answer, okay? So what is a cursed Friday? What number would a cursed Friday be? And what number would Mr. Carter's problems be? In the interest of time, I'm going on to the next one. We're going to revisit these equations in a bit. These are not PSLE questions, so relax, okay? Nothing will happen if you don't win, okay? Or if you don't get it right. Actually, nothing will happen if you don't get a PSLE question correct also. Like, you know, seriously, like, you know, there's more to life than that. Okay. SG Press Freedom minus a clairvoyant sphere. You got this. You got this. Come on. I see you thinking. I see you smiling. Kylie's like, yes, she's just glowing in all her glitter glory. Yeah. Okay. All right. All right. We're going on to the next one. American Horror Story Season 9. Divided by the square of Chinese seafaring immortals. So please pay attention to the operation rules, okay? Like, you know, so for instance, to put it really bluntly, like Chinese seafaring immortals, they are in brackets, right? They're in parentheses, and there is they're squared. So whatever figure that, whatever number that is, you have to put them, you basically have to multiply it by itself before you use it to divide American Horror Story Season 9. Okay. I sound like I'm on something right now, but I promise it's nothing more than red wine. Okay. Is this too difficult? Can I just get a, I don't know, I'm look, everyone looks like the cat right now.
The questions are frightening, man.
Is it frightening? It's doable, lah, Jin Lee. Come on, it's not a PSLE question. And come on, I cannot be giving away. We cannot be giving away here at Press Club the Jabra Panacast 20 for just like easy questions. You know what I mean? You have to work for it. Right or not? Right or not? Correct. Okay. I have a question. What is this question? It is math, magic, and media. There you go. Okay, question four. I thought this was quite easy. Okay, Murdoch's life, because media, divided by the cube root of Pennywise's sleep cycle. Pennywise, of course, from like one of the movies that we discussed earlier. It has a sleep cycle. I need you to take the cube root of that and give me Murdoch's life and divide it by the cube root of that, okay? I promise I was sober when I came out with these questions but they are doable. They are very doable. It's elementary, Watson, I think. Okay. To the Telum folks, it reminds me of the company event that we did, like the virtual escape room. Something, but I think this is much easier. If I were to say so. Okay, really? Question five. Sorry?
Really? That was hard.
Wow, you look at Eugenia. If you want your kids to be good at math, let them watch Ringu. Yes. Okay. Okay, question five. Night Owl Cinematics Origins divided by When Harry Met Hedwig. Okay. By the way, all of these answers are numbers and all these numbers are whole numbers. Okay. I'm not going to give you a decimal point answer or whatever. That's too complicated. Okay. We're not into that. Okay. Because it's October, it's not Avril. Okay. So Night Owl Cinematics Origins divided by When Harry Met Hedwig. Okay. So all you Harry Potter fans and all you Sylvia fans, maybe. You never know. hopefully we know this. Okay, next one. Question six. The square root of Adele's new album multiplied by Aladdin's wishes. Doable, right? If you know your media or music in this case. And if you know your, what do you call that? Fairy tales, I guess. Yes. Or Disney movies. Okay. Next question. Ellen's swan song. Note the spelling of Ellen. Ellen's swan song plus the square root of love potion number. I love the music, by the way. It's just setting the tone. It's like la-di-da, just another Thursday evening at home with my homies. Okay, Ellen's one song plus the square root of love potion number. So take the square root first before you add, okay? And question eight is just all of the above added together. I need your answer 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 to give me question answer 8, okay? Did anyone choose this as their joker round?
No.
No.
No. Okay. Lucky, okay. Nobody.
Yeah, very smart. No, but I feel like...
having the best staff to choose the joker round.
Sorry?
Whoever chose the joker round is having the best laugh.
They are. But apparently nobody. So no one was brave enough to take on math. Okay, do you need me to go through any questions or can I go to the next round? Next round?
No, can you questions, go through please? The questions?
Okay, I thought y'all had given up. Helen and Ivan is easier. Nonsense. Nonsense. I do not believe that. Fake news. Okay, no, no answers yet. Okay. I'll just go very quickly at the end of this, like please submit your forms, okay? Accursed Friday plus Mr. Carter's problems. So basically break down each phrase, like each phrase equals a number. Then you just have to add it all together or divide it or multiply it or whatever it is and you will get another number. Give me that number. As long as the number is right, you are getting the point. Okay, what is Accursed Friday? What numbers most commonly associated with it? And likewise for Mr. Carter's problems, like, you know, who is Mr. Carter? Break it down. You got this. Question two. SG Press Freedom, as of today, minus... a clairvoyant sphere. Okay. So a little bit of the present and a little bit of the future. All right. Question three. American Horror Story Season 9 helps to know what... by the way, it is... I will say here, in case there are any disputes, there's American Horror Story Season 9, the number is not 9, huh? I will not give you the answer just like that. So you have to ask, what is American Horror Story Season 9? And then you take that number and associate it with it and divide it by the square of Chinese seafaring immortals. I promise you I'm still sober. I promise you. All right, question four. Murdoch's life divided by the cube root of Pennywise's sleep cycle. Yeah. Put on your thinking hats. You got this. You got this. Oh, Sushi is back. Vanessa, can you unmute yourself? I just want to... Do you know that has your team told...
I had to go work.
I know, but do you know that you won best dress for your team? Congratulations. Okay, question five. Night Owl Cinematics Origins divided by When Harry Met Hedwig. Again, a number always associated with it. And all the answers are always divisible meaning will result in a whole number. So I will never have you divide something by something and result in a decimal, okay? Or a fraction or whatever, none of that. So it's a whole number. So that might help you inform both sides of the equation. Question 6, Adele's new album. When I say new, is the newest. Square root of that, and then multiply it by Aladdin's wishes, okay? I think that's quite straightforward. And I'm moving on to question 7. Ellen Swan song. Plus the square root of love potion number 9. Okay. And question 8, of course, just add everything together, okay? Jenna, do we have all the answers in, or are people still...
No calculating? Answers yet.
I no answers.
It's going to be zero.
Nick, can you... Sorry, Nick. No, Nick. Sam, can you show the Adele question again?
Sure. Any other requests? I'm just... Yeah.
Question 4.
Question 5.
Sorry?
Question 5.
Yeah.
Okay, 5 and?
4.
4. Okay, I'll go to 5 and 4 in a bit. We'll just go backwards, yeah? Any other requests?
Seven.
Okay, we'll go to 4 and 5 first, okay? I'm kidding, we'll go to 7 first. Ellen's one song plus love potion number. I think I gave a clue there.
Hey Sam, sorry, yeah. The Adele question is question 6, right?
Yeah. Ellen is question number 7. There's a reason why I chose the word song in the first part of the equation also. And I'm going to question 4 now. Murdoch's life thus far. And you take that and divide it by the cube root of Pennywise's sleep cycle, okay? Okay, and moving on to question 5, which someone requested as well. Oh. What's going on? There we go. Wow, a very Hedwig's theme going on. But this is the owl question, because not only do we have Night Owl cinematics, we also have Hedwig the owl. Any questions about this? You can also clarify, but I will try not to spoil it for you. But if you need to clarify, just let me know.
When Harry met
Hedwig, is that the year? When Harry met Hedwig, is that the year that the book that he adopted Hedwig came out?
So I'm not going to answer you directly, but I will just will say this, that when you take Night Owl Cinematics Origins and you divide it, it's divisible by When Harry Met Hedwig. So if you think that it is a year and it's both numbers are divisible by each other, then go for it. But chances are it may be a smaller number, right? You usually take a bigger number and divide it by a smaller number. That's all I'm going to say.
Okay, noted with thanks.
Yep. Okay. Kenna?
Only one submission so far.
Only one submission? Oh my God, y'all. Okay, I just feel bad because I don't want to keep y'all longer than you should be here, you know. But if you don't mind hanging around, yeah.
Sam Jo, last one is 7.
Okay, 7, yeah?
Sorry, there's...
Yeah, number 7.
Sorry. No worries. We'll go to 7. 1 second. Okay. Yep. Ellen Swan Song plus the square root of love potion number. Are you okay? Like, I feel like everyone's okay. So serious right now.
Ragu. Okay, Ragu is in.
Very good, very good. As in Raduga, is it?
Yeah.
Okay, anyone?
I think you made it so difficult.
Oh, is it really difficult? I thought this was easy, actually.
It's damn hard.
Okay, we know what? Educated guess, because it seems that everyone is, you know, finding this of an equal difficulty level, but no, basically...
What I'm learning from this is called bell curve.
Actually, sadly,
it's very inaccessible, by the way.
Wait, sorry?
It's very inaccessible.
That is very rich coming from Isaac Tung, yeah, but... No, and in case y'all don't know, it's because Isaac also runs trivia nights from time to time, and whenever he asks us to do a feedback form, like the most common feedback is your trivia is very inaccessible. So that was his form of revenge. But I will assure you, this is a walk in the park, okay? Compared to his trivia night, retest, yeah, it's okay. You can always retain and take again. Yeah, our team cannot get into it. Guys, it's not PSLE, okay? Relax. Okay. Okay, can we move on? Can we all submit? Just go with it. If you think you know, you know. If you don't know, you don't know.
Hey, all, the last question is add everything up 1 to 7.
Yes, last question.
Hint.
Last question, very easy. My parents want to complain to the examiner, Lily. I thought your daughter might be good at this, actually. Like, you know, no? I feel like she's at the age where she's very in touch with all her mathematical abilities before you grow up and you get jaded and you lose it all and you start using your phone for everything. No? Heiko.
I'm really, like, exhausted right now.
Eugenia, no! I thought you said it was easy. Okay.
No, I mean the company event was okay. Some questions was okay.
This is okay. Okay. Can we all submit now? Can we please submit now? Sorry. We cannot, we don't want to drag this on. I'm just worried about your night. Like, that's all. Like, I'm okay. I can stay here all night, but
I think Halloween came early, man. This is ghastly.
Yeah. Hey, again,
misery, please.
May I remind you that, you know, you need to work hard for the Jabra Panacast 20.
That's true, yes.
All right. So, Jin Lee, every time you complain, remember, you're working hard for the top prize, you know? It doesn't come easy.
Yes.
Yeah.
And question 9 is, what is the price of the first prize?
If you were paying attention, right? Yeah, maybe. Okay. Janet, can I just check in on how many submissions we have?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, all in.
All in. Thank you so much. Okay, thank you so much. Okay, well, Janet's gonna do the calculations. I'm gonna illuminate it for all of you. Please unmute yourselves. Like, just have fun. Okay, it's all relax. I know it's bringing back a lot of trauma, but this is not PSLE. Okay?
Distinction is 3 points.
Bell curve will save you. Okay, so Curse Friday and Mr. Carter's problems. Anyone want to hazard a guess?
Is it 112?
112.
Why?
13 plus 99.
Correct. Because Friday the 13th is considerably unlucky, and Mr. Carter is obviously Jay-Z. If you know his song, he has a song called 99 Problems. So that's 112. Okay. Just a warm-up, okay? That's the easy one. SG Press Freedom. Oh, I didn't like actually. Okay, anyway, here we go. Apparently, Singapore is ranked like in the World Press Freedom Index, 160 currently. Okay, and you take that and you minus the magic 8 ball, which is a clairvoyant sphere. There's a magic 8 ball. You get 152. Did anyone get this right?
Yes.
Oh no. Okay. Well, anyway, I just thought.
Magic.
Sorry.
Got it right. I think it was magic that we got it right.
You did, okay. So at least S-Space got it right. At least S-Space got it right.
We put zero because we thought no press freedom.
Who said that?
Come on, you have to give us the points.
Who said that? Oh, Debra. Suddenly, Debra's mic is working. Okay.
Oh, this is right. It's my earpiece.
So oh, I see her earpiece.
Yeah,
okay.
So it works.
Right.
Oh,
but no.
You have to give it to us. We're telling the truth here.
No, it's zero minus, like, by the way, you're being recorded. Don't worry, this is just for internal use. But zero minus something will be minus something. It cannot be zero. So, you know what I mean? Yeah. It'll be, if zero is minus eight, it'll be minus eight. It won't be, you know, zero. Yeah, unless you multiply it by zero. There you go. Okay, anyway, let's not get into that. But it's a ranking, the ranking. Okay, 160. Now, question three. Oh my God, what is that music? I did not. Okay, it's on my playlist. Sorry, yeah. One second. Question three. American Horror Story Season 9 divided by Chinese Seafaring Immortals. I think I have a feeling Oki Cookie knows this one because, yeah. Isaac Tung, do you want to share with us what the answer might be? Unmute. You can unmute yourself.
No sound.
Let's say 1984 divided by 8 square 31.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, I forgot the square there, but yeah, you, because there are the 8 immortals in Chinese mythology, right? Where they cross the sea. So that is 8 square is 64. And then American Horror Story Season 9 is 1984, that's the title of it. So you get 31. Okay? Question four. I don't mean to traumatize y'all, by the way. I thought this would be fun. Like, okay, Murdoch's life. How old is Murdoch? He is, apparently he is 90. He turned 90 earlier this year. And if you take it, and Pennywise sleeps for 27 years before it emerges again. So you take 90 divided by 3, you get 30. So you know, thing one, Ranjini says, consider us traumatized. I apologize. Question five, Night Owl Cinematics Origins. It was founded. The year was founded. It was founded in 2013. And Harry met Hedwig when he was 11 years old. So 2013 is divided, is divisible by 11. So therefore you get a whole number, 183. If anyone wants to dispute this with me, please just make it be known now. I didn't mean to upset y'all.
No energy.
No energy, okay. Okay. The brain juice all gone, lah, yeah. Okay, got it. But fun, right? This is fun. I'm sure you got some of it right. Okay.
Pain is fun, lah, yeah. Pain is fun. It's okay.
Pain is fun. Pain
but
is
work
fun.
Hard for the camera, yeah.
No pain, no gain. Yeah, exactly. Square root of Adele's new album. Her new album is 25, and Aladdin had 3 wishes. So you take five times 3, you get 15. 15 is the correct answer. Okay. Ellen DeGeneres, obviously, as we all know, she's been cancelled, and her last season is the 19th season, and the famous song is Love Potion number 9. So we get 19 plus the square root of 9. 19 plus 3, we get 22. That is the logic. Okay. I feel very scared right now. I thought this will be more popular. Okay. And we add everything together. For question 8, we get 545.
You know, Sam, this last question is like you play the video games, like you get the platinum achievement. You must achieve all other achievements before you get the platinum achievement.
Yeah. So do you get the platinum achievement or not?
How? We didn't even get silver.
Nobody got it. Because if you get any one of it wrong, your total number is definitely going to be out.
Yeah, I get that. But it's one of those questions. It's a trivia night tradition, you know. So one round will have... The last question will always be a summation of the rest. So I wanted to pay tribute to that. But at the same time also, I figured, like, you know, some of us could handle it, but apparently not. Okay, never mind. We'll move on.
it's acceptable because every PSLE, there's one question that separates the men from the boys.
Well, winging it is giving us, okay, is it negotiable if we add all of our 7 responses, but because it doesn't specify, they have to be the right answers.
Just trying to be too smart. I think the exam doesn't recognize that.
Spur winging it, I can't give you that. I think you make a very good logic, but I can't because then everyone will get a point. Then you getting a point wouldn't even mean anything. So it has to be the correct point.
Yeah, anyway, so, nobody got it correct anyway.
Right, because if you all get a point, then you will all equalize anyway. So okay, getting score and getting one is no.
Bell curve, yo, bell curve.
Bell curve, yeah. Okay, bonus. Okay, I'm sorry, but my decision is final. Okay, let's go to round 5. This is the last round. I promise you it's a lot more lighthearted. It's about how well you know your celebrities. Anyone has chosen this for their Joker round?
Raduga Peeps chose this.
Raduga Peeps. Okay, if you know your celebrities, you go, Spur winging it, I saw your plea, but I'm sorry, no. Because like I said, even if you get one, even if I give you the point, everyone else is going to get the point. So you're not going to get an extra point.
Thanks, Sam. But this is also our joke around, just to, yeah.
Who?
Spur winging it's joke around.
Yeah.
All right, Raduga Peeps and Spur winging it. Out for blood, okay? Like the blood you see on my face. Let's scan the QR code. Let's enter the Google form and let's play. I feel like I'm on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire, except that the prize isn't quite $1 million, but it is a very expensive Jabra video camera and Fullerton dining vouchers. So very good. Okay, everyone is scanning, yeah? I'm going to go ahead to question 1. Okay. Let's go. This one is very, it's easier, I think. Okay. But please send feedback to Janet. Okay, not Sam.
I'll be very nice to you, Sam.
But well, I know, but you know. Okay, I feel the backlash now. I need your answers to be the celebrities, the name of the celebrities who wore these outfits and costumes, okay? So I'm going to show you some outfits and costumes, and they will be, their faces will be covered, of course. If not, it'll be too easy. And you're gonna guess who wore these outfits and costumes. So please enter in your Google form. For instance, question 1, who wore this? Some of these may be Halloween costumes. Some of them may be red carpet events, appearances. Yeah, I think that's pretty much it. Some of them might be even be in like the art that they create. It could be a movie, it could be a TV show. Costumes that they have put on. I need you to guess the celebrity's name, okay? Okay, question 2. Celebrity 2, rather. And 3. You see 2 people here, but I want you to guess the one whose face is covered, okay? Number 4. Oops, was that too soon? Okay, number 5, let's go. The dress says my new album dropped September 18, 2001. Outrageous outfits, I told you. And number 6. Okay, ready? We're going to number 7. Anything that is not covered by the ghost emoji is a clue, okay? Just a little reminder. And final question. Again, when there are more than one people, I need you to guess the person whose face is covered. So that is the answer. Okay, anyone needs me to go through? This is the last question of the whole night. Anyone needs me to go through the all the questions, all the pictures again? One more round?
Please. Yeah, that'd be great. Thanks.
What if I said no? You'd be like, exuant. Okay, let's go back. All right, let's go to number one again. This one has a very big clue. I'm not going to say where, but there's a very, very big clue. Okay, number two. Again, look at what the ghost is not covering, okay? Number three. These are two real people, by the way. So if the person on the right is anything to go by, it shows you the standard of costume that the person that's covered swears by. So that's my biggest clue to you. Okay, question four, the fourth celebrity. Is come on computer, there we go. Again, the clues are behind this person, I think. Or if you've been on social media quite a lot, you might have seen this. That would also be your key to the answer.
Singapore.
Yeah, I mean for sure. Yu Yan Sang.
Okay. This one is Sam Jo. Sam Jo was there.
I was, but I didn't wear this. Okay. This one really, really, really made ripples in, on social media. Okay, anyway, next one. My new album dropped September 18, 2001. So who was like, you know, hot in 2001? Wow, 20 years ago! Betraying my age again, as I say. And the next one. Number six. I think this is quite straightforward, I think. I don't know, maybe. Number seven. And number eight. Again, guess the person in the middle whose face is covered, okay? I'm not interested in the rest, although the rest might help you make an educated guess about who the person in the middle is. All right, do we have all the answers submitted?
Okay, let me check. One just came in. Two.
All right.
Three.
Whoops, not yet. Okay. Let me know, yeah? Okay, I will just take Janet's cue from when everyone has submitted, but if you can do it in the next half a minute, that would be great.
Not yet.
Hey, at this point, it's you either know or don't know, yeah? It's one of those things, right? Okay. Well, that wraps up all the questions for tonight. Thank you so much for being so sporting.
Six. One more.
Okay.
Zeno two, please.
Zeno two? Zeno, thank you.
Okay, in.
All
okay,
in?
Let me just check all the answers first, okay?
All right, Janet's going to tabulate the scores. By the way, I hope each of you are tabulating your own scores as well, just in case you want to dispute anything, we are open for discussion, okay? So it's not like an autocracy here or whatever. Like, you know, we are very open. Yeah, as much as we look crazy, we are actually not. We are very rational people, human beings, okay? All right. So let's go through the answers. I think you might be interested to know who this is. Anyone wants to guess? I think the big clue really is, well, for me, would be the butterfly ring on the finger. Anyone wants to guess who this is? Unmute yourselves.
Mariah Carey.
Who said that? Kara said that. Yes, Mariah Carey is known to love butterflies. She named an album after it, and so that is her, dressed as a mermaid for Halloween. I'm just putting her full name in case anyone has like different components of her name and everything, but Mariah Carey will get you the full point, okay? But fun fact, her middle name is Angela. Who knew? Question two, anyone could guess this? You can tell from his stubble maybe and how campy the whole outfit is. And the fact that he's in LA, Los Angeles, which is the red carpet clue at the back. Anyone want to guess who this is?
I think it's Adam Lambert.
Who said that? Heiko?
Me, Heiko, yeah.
Okay, Heiko.
Yes, my friend.
I've seen this picture.
You are absolutely right, Heiko. Adam Mitchell Lambert, or just Adam Lambert will do. You get a full point also. Apparently, his middle name is Mitchell with one L. So today, I was 2 years old when I learned that. But yeah, this was him at a Halloween party and he was a genie. Very nice. Okay, who wants to guess who this is?
Yona.
Huh? Who?
Fiona.
Fiona, yeah, we know it's Fiona from Shrek, but who?
Heidi Klum.
No.
Who said that?
Spelling.
Spelling it. You think it's Heidi? Really?
Well, not now.
You are right. It's Heidi. Heidi Klum. By the way, I need to pay homage to her because she is the queen of Halloween. Okay. She is basically, she just takes things like further than anyone can imagine. And the guy beside her is actually Seal when they were still together. So yeah, that's just how much of a transformation each of them made. And so I must say respect to her. But yeah, this is one of the most famous Halloween costumes. She was Fiona from Shrek. All right. So good job, Spur, winging it. I think this is your Joker round. So 2 points for you. Good job. Who is this from Star Wars? was it this year or last year? I can't remember. But this was quite a recent phenomenon. I say phenomenon only because it created a splash on social media and everyone called this the Bandung suit, you know, because it looks like Bandung, right? Like the drink Bandung where you mix carnation milk and rose syrup. Anyone knows who this is?
Alvin Ng.
Who?
Alvin Ng.
Alvin Ng. You are right. And if you put his Chinese name because he's a, you know, Channel 8 actor, Ng Chun Xiong or like Ng Huang Jun Xiong or whatever, we would accept that as well, okay? Yeah. But Alvin Ng...
Well, apparently his Nick's classmate or something, and that's why we got this right.
Is it?
Schoolmate or classmate or some mate.
Inside information. Inside information.
The information, yeah. Oh, so
I
Nick...
I don't know who he is.
Nick's classmate.
Even with his mask and mask, I don't know who he is.
He is one of the more famous actors. Yeah. But wow, so Nick, I know how old Nick is already based on this. Yeah. Where's Nick? He disappeared.
He has a call.
Oh, he has a call. Okay, no wonder. Okay, but at least he contributed there, yeah? Okay, question five. I had to throw in some local stuff, you know, because we're Singapore after all, right? So we have to, yeah. My new album drops September 18, 2001. The new album was called The Id. And she had songs like Sweet Baby featuring Erykah Badu and oh my god, I'm blanking out right now. I'm trying not to get the wrong album. Sexual Revolution. So this was Macy Gray, one of my all-time favorites. If you put her real name, Natalie McIntyre, or Natalie Renee McIntyre, I'll give you the point as well. But more famously, she's known as Macy Gray. And she famously wore this album to plug her album in at the 2001 VMAs, 20 years ago as well. Again, I'm showing my age. Okay. Next, I think this is a no-brainer. I hope so. If any of you have been to the movies recently, you would have watched Shang-Chi. And this is not Simu Liu, but Tony Leung. And please get the right Tony Leung. So if you put like, you know, Ka Fai cannot. It has to be Chu Wai, okay? Because there are two famous Tony Leungs in Hong Kong. Okay. But if you put Tony Leung, we give you the point anyway, okay? Okay, okay. We're moving on to question 7. I'm just wary about the time. And I'm just trying to give Janet more space also to breathe. Well, we go. We're lagging again. Sorry about that, everyone. But all right. Who do we think this is?
David Bowie.
Yes, it is David Bowie. And or if you go by his birth name, David Robert Jones, we'll give you the point either way. And the big clue was his red hot mullet. All right. And he was obviously known for his like outrageous costumes, which is like, you know, really the inspiration for this category, if you ask me. So rest in peace, David Bowie. And we celebrate you and all great costumes that you have put together. Now, last one. Do we know who this group is? I think so. All the 90s, 80s kids would kind of know it. You know, these are actually the Backstreet Boys. Dressed up in for Halloween in the outfits that they wore in Everybody Backstreet's Back video, in that video. And you know, so obviously you have like, you know, the zombie and the vampire and everything and the phantom. And Nick Carter was the mummy in the middle. So if you entered Nick Carter or Nicholas Carter or Nicholas Jean Carter, if you want to be specific, apparently his name is spelled with a K. We'll give you the point, full point. All right. Big money. Woo! And that's the end. Oh my goodness. I'm very excited and I'm very excited to find out who won. I'm going to check in with Janet. Janet is going to WhatsApp me the results right now.
Yeah. Yep. Okay.
But before that, because I know she needs more time, I'm just going to do a little plug for Singapore Press Club because, as you know, this whole event and this entire extravaganza is only possible because of the Singapore Press Club. Where we connect media professionals and we are celebrating our 50th anniversary still, because it's still 2021, not for very much longer, only 2 more months. Can you believe it, how time flies? So we do have a special limited time membership fee promo of pay 2, get 3 years. And if you want more details, please head on over to our website. You know, you can sign up there and you can also get more details about membership categories and fees, okay? Or you can email me, you can email Janet. Just look us up on LinkedIn or whatever socials you have us on. Or you can also reach out to secretariat@pressclub.org.sg. Okay, sorry, mandatory plug. Okay, I didn't mean to get all businessy on all of you. But we are going to find out who has won the coveted third prize in just a bit. And I'm getting a... All right, I got the results from Janet. So in the meantime, I'm going to stop sharing. I'm going to key in the results so that I can announce it to you. Janet, do you want to tell us more about the press club or anything, or like anyone else who wants to speak or give feedback about tonight? I see Lilin was very excited about Alvin Ng earlier. I'm just going to update the slides with the winners in very quickly and then we'll be with you shortly.
Yeah. Anyway, yeah. The press club is getting very exciting nowadays because we are doing a lot of... in programs, and never mind about COVID, we've started everything going digital and we are making it fun as much as possible. Like we are doing some Deepavali dinner deliveries in 2 weeks time. So although you can't dine together outside, you can still dine at home, you know. So these are programs that we do that we bring along we introduce interesting Michelin star chefs menu curated for our members as well as whoever want to join. Of course, members get special rates as usual. And we are also doing a few other talks as well. Generations is a new talk series we've just started a week ago. Jin Lee is our regular host every alternate month and on the second Wednesday of the month. And we're going to be talking to various you know, media and PR professionals about the different generations' way of thinking about the media scene as well, how they work. So do join us if you can. And last but not least, we also have a very serious news impact talk, alternating with generations. And this is also on the second Wednesday of every month as well at lunchtime. Well, and that is going to be all about talking about news impact stories, something about health, something about sustainability, maybe, you know, any other topics that will be of interest to the news. So do join us for these programs as we progressively make Singapore Press Club more interesting and exciting. And we will start our monthly networking last Thursday of every month, so that members and guests and friends like you can join us to actually network. That is when we are allowed to go and party as one big group, okay? So hopefully you'll join us.
Yes, thank you so much, Janet. And we're ready. And thanks for sharing all of that. That's very useful information. If you ever are curious, just Google Singapore Press Club, or you can ask any of us of the committee members here in the chat tonight. Okay, I'm Sam Jo. Obviously, you have Junie, you have Jin Lee, you have Janet. We, you know, MVP of Singapore Press Club. I will say we have the results in hand. Am I sharing it right now? Yes, I am. Okay, I'm gonna give it to y'all. Hopefully we can all have a physical event soon, and you know, we all miss that, I'm sure, like, you know, that human touch. So we're looking forward to seeing everyone. But till then, these are the winners, okay, for tonight. Thank you so much for playing. I know we've run way over time, but I hope this was fun for you. In third place, and getting, you know, not only Fullerton dining vouchers, but also a bottle of white wine, I have clicked.
No, it's not moving.
It's not moving. I know. It's doing that again. Well, one of those things.
Halloween.
But...
the score.
What's the score? Sorry? Like?
The score.
All right, here we go. No, we're going to announce the winners because we see the score, then you know the winners. We want to surprise you, okay? So please drum roll, everybody. In third place, winning a bottle of wine worth $40 and... dining vouchers, $50 worth of dining vouchers from the Fullerton Hotel Singapore. Please give it up for team. Oh, wait. Team, you don't think too.
Good strategy. One and yeah. Two.
Yeah, your strategy paid off. Like, you know, two. Well, will Zeno think one also make the podium? We will see. Okay. But anyway, all prizes. We will be in touch with you. We have your contact details. We'll be in touch with you about the collection of it, okay? Congratulations again, the third prize. No mean feat, considering you were up against, like, you know, quite a few other teams, okay? We're all very cerebral. So congratulations, Zeno thing, and Zeno in general, okay, for even making it. Second place, well, I have someone saying in the chat here. Congrats, yes, Tim saying congrats. All right, in second place, getting the bottle of whiskey worth $118, as well as, again, thanks to our sponsor, Fullerton, you know, 5 times 15. How much is that? It's okay. I'm not going to traumatize you all again.
75.
Apparently, it adds up. Yeah, 5 times 15. Apparently, it all adds up to 193. I will take their word for it. I will take Jen's word for it. And the winner of the second prize is none other than Team Tellum!
Moving up the ranks, Team Tellum.
Yes, I'm so happy. Okay, congratulations, Team Tellum. But of course, everyone was here for the grand prize, the grand prize of the Jabra Panacast 20 video camera worth $464. On top of that, you get Fullerton Hotel Singapore dining vouchers worth $100. So we're talking about more than $500 of prizes. Who walked away tonight? Who is going to walk away tonight with the top prize?
Drum roll.
And the winner is... Congratulations! Oh, wait, it's lagging again. Okie Cookie! Yes, thank you so much. And you know what? As much as the winners have a lot to celebrate about, please, everyone who has taken part tonight, give yourselves a round of applause. I know I can't hear you, but please, really, like, you know, thank you for taking the time and, like, engaging in this really nerdy activity for Halloween, no less, and putting together your costumes. Like, I hope this was fun for you. I hope, at the very least, you walked away with, like, some new knowledge, okay? And we're going to take a very quick photo right now just to, you know, show everyone that we were here on the 28th of October 2001, because we are not sure how long the world is going to go on spinning for, given this pandemic. So let's just, you know, enjoy it while we can, right? Okay, so I'm going to take a couple of screenshots and we're going to go, I don't know, say something. We're going to go, what are we going to say? What do you want to say? Happy Halloween, because it ends in a smile. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Happy Halloween!
Happy Halloween.
And one more for the other page, because there's so many of you. 1, 2, 3. Happy Halloween! All right. Thank you so much for taking part in today's trivia night. We really, really appreciate your presence. And yeah, that's basically it. Congratulations, all the winners. Did Spur win come in last? Okay, actually, I don't have the score sheet.
I can show.
I'm going to stop sharing, and Janet's going to share it with y'all. So... Okay, Lily is going to see a psychologist. I apologize for that. Yeah. All right. Right. So as we can see, Okie Cookie came in tops. Tellum and then Xeno thing two. Raduga Peeps, you just missed it with 31 points. It seems like the 2 points that you got for your costume couldn't save you. If only you had gotten two more points.
Sorry. What? I didn't get the 2 points.
Oh.
So, but then if it's a tie, then how?
Wow, we have a tie. We have a live tie in front of us. What should we do?
Then how?
Yeah, they have
another 5 rounds of tiebreaker.
What?
Huh? Do another 5 rounds of tiebreaker.
Oh, no.
I actually didn't do this tiebreaker. Okay, we'll get to that. But Jenna, can you update the score first? 33. Then, okay, we'll go to Spur winging it. You just missed it with 30. Xeno thing one. Oh my goodness. Half a point. And stabilization phase, you had a good start, but unfortunately, you fell to last place. But congratulations, everyone.
Okay, we are stabilized.
Spur winging it. I'm sure I'll see you on the podium next time. So we have two teams tied for third place. Janet, do we have enough prizes to give everyone a prize, or do we need to do a tiebreaker question?
Well, I don't really have the extra vouchers to give.
Okay, let's do a tiebreaker, and the person that can answer my question right now, the first team. So I'm talking specifically to Xeno Thing 2 and Raduga Peeps. I'm sorry, Xeno Thing 2, for getting your hopes up, but this is a bit like a La La Land and Moon and what do you call that, Moonlight, right? So I need you to both answer my question in the chat. The first team that types into the correct answer into the chat for this tiebreaker question will win the third prize, okay? I'm sorry we have to do this, but, like, you know, it's just one of those things. Like, you know, numbers and numbers. Okay, so here we go. Raduga Peeps and Xeno Thing 2, are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm ready.
Okay, the first one to type it into the chat, okay?
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking of the question as we go along, because but this will happen. Okay, let's go. It's a very simple one, and we just talked about it. Who is the celebrity who also has the nickname the Queen of Halloween? Please give it to me now. The first team that types it into the chat will win the third prize. I need you. Okay, Zeno Thing 1, but this is not for you to play. Okay, hi, Zeno Thing 2, you have kept. Yes, we know. I think they got it. Zeno Thing 1, I'm going to give it to Zeno Thing 2.
No, RP came first.
Who?
Radical P.
Yeah, we said it first.
RP came answered first because I think Zeno 1.
Full name, Ani. Heidi, there's a lot of Heidis in the wall.
Wow, wow, wow. Okay.
Preach. No, I say here Heidi Klum.
Yeah.
And Heidi.
RP gave the answer Heidi Klum.
What? Oh, shit.
I'm willing to give them a benefit of doubt because I do feel like when Zeno Thing 2 said Heidi, they wouldn't have just said any Heidi. So they're not gonna. It's okay. Let's do another tiebreaker question, okay?
I actually typed a direct message to the wrong person. But we typed it first and then it went to the wrong person.
Hmm? Well, I'm sorry, but you know, it has to go to everyone. And no one got a direct message as far as I'm concerned. So it's okay, we're all back to square one. Let's do another tiebreaker question. This is nail biting.
Another one.
Everyone is so excited to see who can win the bottle of white wine.
So make sure you put it to everyone now.
Okay, everyone now. No, but only the two teams that are up for third place, lah, right? So we're talking about Zeno Thing
2 and Rabu.
Raduga. No one else spoil it for them, okay? Zeno Thing 2 and Raduga Peeps, okay? Please tell me, fastest fingers first, who... I'm coming up this question as we speak. but it will be one of those things that we talked about, okay? Be one of those things that we talked about. Okay, it's very easy. I'll just give you an easy one. Give me, what is the date of All Saints Day? What is the date of All Saints Day? Zeno Thing, no, Raduga Peeps, you got it wrong. So Zeno Thing 2, you have kept your prize. Congratulations. I said All Saints Day, not All Saints Eve. All Saints Day is November 1st. Congratulations, Zeno Thing 2, Kylie, with your amazing, you know, you and your teammates and your amazing unicorn, like onesie. Thank you so much for participating. Raduga Peeps, better luck next time. Thank you so much, though, Pete from Agilvy. I really, really, really appreciate you being here tonight. Please come back again for the next trivia night. Everyone, thank you so much. I know this has been exhausting. I will personally apologize for the math round, but I thought that was I thought we could go a bit nerdy, but I guess, like, you know, maybe I went overboard. But I hope you all have a great weekend. And remember, thank you so much to our sponsors, also you know, Fullerton Hotel and Resorts, as well as Jabra, you know, for giving us such a good time and like for such amazing prizes to work towards, you know. And thank you, of course, to Singapore Press Club for making all of this possible. This is amazing. I hope all of you have an amazing week ahead and the rest of the weekend. It's Halloween weekend. However way you want to celebrate it, dressing up, not dressing up, or just spending time with your loved ones. We all know we need more of that these days. Thank you. Please have a good time.
Let's promote the January one, the New Year one.
Yeah, we do. Thank you, Jenna. You want to do that? It's coming up in January, right?
Right. Yeah. Sometime third week of January next year. We're going to celebrate spring. Yeah? So remember to join us back again.
Yeah, there will be something like spring, what do you call that? Spring theme. So we haven't really put it all together yet, but rest assured there'll be another trivia night with even with better, if not like, you know, similar, if not even better prizes up for grabs. Okay. So tell all your friends about this and tell all your friends about Singapore Press Club. Okay. Thank you so much for joining us today. Good night and all the best.
Thanks.
Good night. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
You look not normal again.
this is as good as it gets. Not really. This is the real horror story here.
Really?
Oh, that was fun.
Thanks for joining, Tim. Thank you.
I think we need to ban Ookie Cookie from playing again.
They're too good, right?
Yeah.
Sam Jo, I thought you were going to dress up.
I ran out of time. This was the best I could do. This is the best.
That year day. Do I look good?
Yeah. Yeah, Janet, by the way, put a costume together in like in 5 minutes.
Got a Daiso, man. Daiso today.
That was fun.
Yes. Oh my god. I'm so exhausted now. Janet can start recording.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, guys. Thanks so much. Great job.